Hello everyone. Today we will going to discuss the topic fatigue. So very essential thing, what is fatigue? Fatigue is basically a component when subjected to cyclic loading at a stress which is considerably lower than the yield stress or the static loading. In general, we apply cyclic loading on the specimen. For example, if we see in the this schematic here, where applied stress is in the form of schematic cyclic loading here. Some important parameter of this cyclic loading, that is sigma max, sigma min and mean stress. The cyclic loading, which is defined by basically the range of stress which is lies between sigma max to sigma min, it is a difference of this maximum stress and minimum stress. Another very important component, that is stress amplitude, sigma a, which is the half of range of this stress amplitude, which is sigma max minus sigma min by 2. Another concept is mean stress, which is the average of this maximum stress and minimum stress, that is sigma max plus sigma min by 2. Another very important concept, that is stress ratio, which is the ratio of minimum stress and maximum stress. This stress ratio is very much important to decide the experimental conditions where we are going to start our experiments in the under cyclic loading conditions. Now, there are three different types of fatigue loading or time varying stresses. The first one is completely reversed loading, where mean stress is zero, and another condition is minimum stress, which is exactly opposite to the maximum stress, that is sigma min is equal to the minus of sigma max. The second important time varying stress is repeated loading, where minimum stress must be zero, but here we can clearly observe from this schematic there, sigma min should not be equal to zero. So this is the definition of repeated loading. The third one is the fluctuating loading, where we can clearly observe from the schematic that the here minimum stress should not be zero. This minimum stress either in the tensile regime or in the compressive regime. Obviously here mean stress and maximum stress is also not zero. Now we are going to discuss, there are two different types of fatigue loading. The one is high cycle fatigue, another one is low cycle fatigue. When we can say our specimen is subjected to which kind of cycle? It is basically depends upon the number of cycle which is sustained by the specimen under cyclic loading. When our specimen is sustained for 1000 number of cycle and cross 1000 number of cycle, so we can say our specimen is designed for high cycle fatigue. But eventually when our specimen fails under the 1000 number of cycles, so it is generally known as the low cycle fatigue. Another parameter is when our specimen is operated under the well below under the yield strength of the specimen, which is static loading condition. So our specimen is when well below under the yield stress condition, so it run for the higher number of cycle, which is near about somewhere 1 million cycle or more than that. So in that case also we can say our specimen is designed for high cycle fatigue. But when our specimen is operated very near to the yield strength of static loading condition, then sometimes it's not only lies in the elastic regime, but it's also sometimes enter into the elastic plastic zone also. So in that condition, our specimen will sustain for less number of cycle when we compare or when we make the difference of 1000 number of cycle, or we can say our specimen is fails under the 1000 number of cycle. In that case, we can say specimen is designed for low cycle fatigue. This is the SN curve, which is one of the oldest approach to understand the fatigue loading. This SN, from the SN curve, we can clearly observe here when a specimen is failed under this 1000 number of cycle. So this is the stage one of the stage one of the fatigue loading. If specimen fail under this condition, so this is low cycle fatigue. But our specimen is when crosses 3 number of cycles and reaches up to the 10 to about 6 number of cycle. Here we can clearly observe this SN curve, which is the best fitted curve over the several specimen tested. So when it becomes like almost asymptotic at which particular stress amplitude it becomes asymptotic, below which when we operate our specimen under for cyclic loading, so specimen is sustained for infinite number of cycles. So this is basically known as something endurance limit of the specimen. But some material which is not showing the nature of this kind of red line curve, which is SN curve. So in that cases, this SN curve goes down and down, and at some point it becomes zero stress amplitude. But when a specimen reaches the 10 to the power 8 number of cycle, at which particular stress this number of cycle they are giving, that is basically known as the fatigue strength. So fatigue strength is basically shown by the low strength alloys such as magnesium or aluminium alloys, but endurance limit is in case of ferrous material or titanium alloy. The third approach, which is the linear elastic fracture mechanics approach, or LEFM. LEFM is basically when this is the case of where we have already have a pre-crack, which is signified, which is the representation of crack initiation. But from this particular point, where we apply the cyclic loading, and when this cyclic loading become critical from initial position to the crack become critical, up to this point, how much number of cycle specimen sustained, that is basically defined by or evaluated by the linear elastic fracture mechanics approach. Thank you.